Hello viewers, this is mock test 13, so let's continue. Channel current is reduced on application of a more positive voltage to the gate of a depletion mode and channel MOSFET. See, depletion mode, as we know that depletion mode has a permanent channel induced between the source and drain terminals. Depletion mode and channel MOSFET has a P-type of substrate, okay? So it is always in on state. It is always normally known as on transistor. It is normally known as on transistor. Okay. So if I want to keep it off, then I have to apply some control voltage which can usually make this transistor off. And if I apply some control voltage, then it will remove the channel. This control voltage remove the channel, which will make it as off transistor. Okay, so depletion mode and channel MOSFET is normally known as on transistor, and if we want to remove the channel from it, then we should apply some control voltage which can remove the channel and make it as a off transistor. If like this is the MOSFET, okay, this is N plus, this is also N plus, this is P type substrate, and here it is, this is a SiO2 layer, okay, this is gate terminal and this is drain terminal. Okay, so if some voltage is applied, whether it is positive or negative, then it will attract the electrons or repel the electrons due to the minority carriers present in this P substrate. For example, if the gate voltage is applied as positive, if I apply the positive gate voltage, then it will try to attract the electrons, because the minority charge carriers in P substrate are electrons. Okay, so these electrons, and this is here we are applying positive gate voltage. So actually, this positive gate voltage and this electrons both are positively charged particles, so both will try to attract each other. Unlike charges attract each other, and if they attract each other, then the channel current increases. If positive gate voltage is applied, then channel gets induced, more charge carriers will form, more charge carriers form, and so therefore more current flows, more drain current flows. But if I apply the negative gate voltage, for example this much, then negative and the negative electrons, which are also negatively charged from the P substrate, both are like charges will repel each other, and hence the channel will not be get induced, and less charge carriers will form, and or we can say that no drain current will flow. So these electrons, if I apply positive gate, if I like the condition here negative, on applying the negative gate voltage, less charge carriers will be formed, less charge carriers will form, and less drain current will flow, less drain current flows. And if I apply more negative gate voltage, then on applying more negative gate voltage, then no drain current will flow. So this means that on the application of positive or negative gate voltage, the induced channel, the channel can be induced and the channel can be reduced, and in this way the channel current can also be increased or decreased. So here, when this positive gate voltage is applied on the gate terminal, then it will try to attract the electrons from this P substrate. So the electrons will try to attract each other, and they will be coming in this N channel, and from this N channel they will try to collect in this SiO2 layer, because SiO2 layer is a dielectric, it acts as an insulator, so they will be settled before the SiO2 layer. So hence, if the question, in the question it is given the channel current is reduced on the application of a more positive voltage. So more positive voltage means more channel, the channel will be more positive voltage means that more charge carriers will be induced in the channel and hence more current will flow. So the channel current is reduced, it is wrong statement, because the channel current is not reduced, it is mainly increased. It is mainly increased. So this statement is false. So this is the right answer. If I draw the drain characteristics, for example ID versus VDS at constant VGS, here this is VGS, okay, here if VGS is kept at 0 volt, here it is at 0.5 volt, it is 1 volt, and here it is minus 0.5 volt, it is minus 1 volt. So as you can see, this is IDSS. If the gate voltage is 0, so IDSS will be maximum. If the gate voltage is negative, the drain current is going towards negative side. If the gate voltage is increasingly positively, like 0.5 volt, 1 volt, drain current enhances. So this is what? This is ohmic region and this is saturation region. So VDS is the drain to source output voltage. So that means on the application of positive gate voltage, the charge carriers will increase, so more channel current will flow, and if the gate voltage is negative, then the charge carriers will reduce and the less channel current will flow. So the answer is false. Channel current is increased on the application of more positive voltage to the gate of a depletion mode N-channel MOSFET. Next question. The breakdown voltage of a transistor with its base open is BVCU and that with emitter open is BVCBU. Then, now, which condition is true? Which condition is true? As we know, whenever we go to buy the transistor in the market, so we have to keep in mind the two conditions. My drawing is not so good. Okay, first of all we see its maximum collector current, and then the second is power dissipation, maximum how much power it can dissipate, which is mentioned in the data sheet. So the transistor can be configured in three ways: common base, common emitter, common collector. Okay, so if I talk about common emitter transistor configuration, here the emitter is kept common, but the it is base is kept open, and the collector is kept at output side. So here the maximum power dissipation, is ICO into BVCEO. Okay, this is maximum reverse saturation current. Okay, now since ICEO is equal to beta plus 1 of ICBO, we can also, this is known as collector to base current with emitter open, ICBO. So since this is the equation, so I can also write it as beta plus 1 of ICO, because this is what? This is leakage current. And so you can say, since ICEO is greater than ICBO, therefore BVCBO is greater than BVCEO. So the answer is BVCBO is greater than BVCEO. So the answer is C. BVCBO is greater than BVCEO. Okay, next question. A BJT is said to be operating in saturation region. We know that BJT is a current control device. It operates in saturation region when its both junctions, emitter to base junction and collector to base junction, are forward biased. For example, if I talk about common emitter configuration, this is NPN. So this is what? Emitter, base and collector. So NPN means, N means what? Negative, it is forward biased. P means positive. And here for reverse bias condition, N means negative, so it will be go opposite side. So this is what? This is saturation state. No, this is in active, sorry, this is active region. This is what? Active region. Because here it is forward bias and it is reverse bias. Because emitter base junction is forward bias and collector to base junction is reverse bias. So here a BJT is said to be operating in saturation region if both junctions are forward biased. This is the answer. Okay, next question. Ewer's small model is applicable to BJTs only. It is neither applicable to NMOS transistors, nor uni UJTs, nor JFET. JFET is a voltage control device and BJT is a current control device. So Ewer's small model is only applicable to BJTs. Okay, next question. The early effect in BJTs caused by, this is very important, early effect, always asked. Early effect is also known as base width modulation. That means when we apply reverse jump, reverse bias, we can say that as the reverse bias across collector to base junction, whenever as the reverse bias across collector to base junction is increased, okay, then what will happen, that is VCB, as the collector to base voltage increases, which implies reverse bias at collector junction increases, which implies that depletion region width increases, which implies that more penetration into the base region, okay, which implies the effective base width reduces, that means the recombination is reduced. So early effect increases. So the early effect in BJT is caused by, we can say, large collector base reverse bias. Early effect means, or base width modulation means, the variation in the width of the base due to the variation in the applied collector to base voltage in reverse bias condition. Depletion region mainly penetrates to the lightly doped region. Okay, so increase of depletion region penetrates under lightly doped side, that is base. For example, this is ammeter, this is base, and this is collector. Okay, so this layer is called effective base width. This is called as metallurgical width. Okay, so when change in the early effect means change in the width of the base, fixed at any voltage. Here we can say that this is depletion region. Depletion region, it consists of the immobile charge carriers. This is depletion region. This is what? Depletion region. It consists of positive donor ions and negative acceptor ions, which are immobile in nature. So on the application of the reverse bias voltage across collector to base junction, when this reverse bias junction voltage is increased, then the depletion region penetrates more towards the lightly doped region. This base region is what? This is lightly doped region. So that means this is effective base width. So this effective base width reduces, so recombination is reduced. So that means the early effect increases. The early effect increases due to large collector to base bias voltage. So this is the right answer. For any queries, please share comments, and thanks for liking this video. Thank you very much. Please like my video. Thank